guys, this is Vasa from the FTC Tacobots, and today I'll be demonstrating how to write a basic TeleOp and autonomous program. So what is TeleOp and what is autonomous? In the robot game in FTC, each team is given 30 seconds at the beginning to complete the autonomous portion of the game. This is a pre-written program where the robot acts on its own and moves as written in the program. In TeleOp, which consists of a 2-minute game, the robot is given a pre-written code. In this pre-written code, the robot is given a list of commands to complete based on human control, which is done through the Logitech or Xbox controllers, meaning the driver moves the joystick on a controller, the robot will move accordingly. Without further ado, let's get into this tutorial. So let's first open Android Studio. And open your FTC SDK. Okay, so I want us to get into project, right? And then get into the FTC Robot Control Master, then get into team code, SRC main java org.firstinspires.ftc.teamcode, okay? So once we get in there, let's make a new Java class. And let's just call this basic TeleOp. Okay, so first thing I want to do is I want us to kind of get a gist or the understanding of the different types of op modes. The difference between linear op mode and iterative op mode is that in a regular op mode, also known as an iterative operative mode, the program runs in a loop. Anything that needs to be executed in that loop will be done without stepping over any other commands that the robot has been asked to complete. However, in a linear op mode, which is ideal for autonomous, the op mode waits till each function has been completed before it starts a new command. In other words, it follows a list of steps to complete. So for TeleOp, let's create an iterative op mode. So right, extends, op mode, and press tab. And every single time you are writing a method or filling out a function, you always have to press tab so that it imports the methods or implements the methods. Okay, so now we have written which op mode we're gonna use. Next, what we have to do is we need to identify and configure the motors of the robot. In our case, we have 4 motors. So we are, or for our robot, we're gonna use front left, front right, back left. So private DC motor front left equals nulls its value, and at the beginning it will be set to nothing. And do this for the other 4 motors, or other 3 motors now. Okay, so we have now configured, or not really configured, but we have now set our motors. So next, what I want to talk about is the init. The init is the initialize button on the robot phone. When you press initialize, the robot gets in a stage, which is pre-handed to the program, but kind of initializes all the motors so that they're ready in the robot game. So in this, what we do is we use hardware map, and what hardware map does, it gives the robot the ability to be interactive with the controller. This ultimately means that the robot will move when it's asked to. Okay, so the way we do or write a hardware map is, so let's say we're going with front left, right? So front left equals hardware map dot to get DC motor dot class device name, and this will be front left. Always end off every line of code with either a semicolon or parentheses, or sorry, bracket. Next, we do that for front right. And repeat this for all the motors, actually. Okay, so now we have let the robot's motors be interactive with the control hub. So when it's asked to move, it will move. Next, what we do, so this is in the init, right? So since we're using four motors and not all four motors are gonna be configured in the same position as the rest, we have to reverse two, either on the left side or the right side. So to make programming easier, we are gonna configure the right-hand side of motors to be in reverse so that they're moving, or when programmed, they move the same way as the left motors. So that means that we are gonna set front to right dot set direction chin DC motor dot direction and now set this for your back right. Okay. And once you guys have done this for the back right, we can start writing in the loop. This is the actual main portion of the programming, and it's also going to be for the basic TeleOp, of course. It's going to be the easiest portion of the programming. What we do is we write back right, which is a back right wheel, which will be controlled by the gamepad joystick. Okay, so for the right wheels, we'll set them to the right joystick. For the left wheels, we'll let them for the left joystick, because there are two joysticks on a controller. And the Y axis, which is the up and down movement on a joystick, is going to be the direction that will control the actual motors for the wheels. So we set this power actually to minus gamepad one dot right stick Y, because it's the right wheel. Then do that for the back left, except for this time, we're gonna use the left joystick. So gamepad one, of course, dot left stick Y. I'll do this for the front right. Okay, and that's your basic TeleOp program. Yeah, thank you for watching.